this screencast, I'm going to go over the basics of understanding the structure of the OpenAPI 2.0 specification. Now, please be advised, there is another version of the spec out there, 3.0, and it's gaining acceptance. The tool sets to supporting 3.0 are a little bit behind, so within a year, we're going to see more usage of 3.0 as the common standard. But right now, there's a lot of 2.0 out there, OpenAPI 2.0, so I'm going to focus on that. The structures between the versions are different, but conceptually things are almost identical. So the stuff you learn here is going to be useful. And then if you use SwaggerHub, which is what I use, you're going to be able to use Convert to OpenAPI 3.0 to upgrade your specification to the 3.0 version. So but right now we're 2.0. So OpenAPI is a specification for declaring APIs. It's hierarchical with some base attributes or properties, and then there's sub-properties along the way. You can express or write out the specification in JSON, which I do because I'm a JSON head, or you can use YAML. And just to show you that indeed you can use YAML, I'm going to take this and I'm going to show you the YAML version of my specification very quickly. You can see there it is in YAML. So again, if you're a YAML head, you can specify your API under OpenAPI in YAML, or if you're a JSON head like me, you can use JSON. Okay, the OpenAPI specification has 8 root elements and that describe various aspects of the API. The first one is Swagger, which is the version declaration, because right now we're 2.0. If this was 3.0, it would say Swagger 3.0. We have info, which it declares information about the API that's of interest on a semantic level to users. I've made a demo API, Movie Rater. The purpose of the API is to allow people to rate movies based on data drawn from IMDb. And it describes that in the info section. The next section is tags, and tags are where you can define groups. And group definitions are going to become very important when we start adding layers of security onto API access, because we'll be able to give certain groups access to some endpoints and exclude other groups from such access. And that will come out in the tag section. And you can see one of the nice things about Swagger Hub is that it will immediately render the documentation that we describe in the Swagger specification or the OpenAPI specification, and it will render it on the right-hand side. So there's my admins and developers tags along with the descriptive language I put in there. The next root attribute is paths. And paths is the entry point to the API after base path. Base path, which is a root property, describes exactly where all API calls will enter first. It's the root entry point. And then all other paths declared within the path section will descend from the base path. And you can see under paths here, I have 3 paths. I have movies, ratings, and users. Movies has an HTTP GET method that will be described in detail in the subsequent sections, JSON sections, of the property. But for right now, the thing you'll need to understand is that movies is the path, and it's supporting HTTP GET to retrieve data. That data will come from IMDb. Ratings, it's the next path. It supports the HTTP POST method and the HTTP GET method. POST allows people to, or developers, or people using the API, to put ratings into the system. And GET, HTTP GET, allows developers to extract one or many ratings from the system according to search criteria. Users allows a developer to declare people who are making ratings in the system. So for example, if I wanted to make a rating, I'd first have to be registered as a user, and then we will use my email address as the identifier in movies by which I will make a rating. Anyway, so here's path, and I'm going to go into all of this in subsequent videos because there's a lot of detail to each aspect of the specification. Definitions is where we describe models that will be used by the API. In other words, for models, it's data structures, or if you're from an object-oriented background, you can think of them as objects. Okay, properties with values. And so right now we have in the definitions, we have movies, genre, rating, known rating, and users. Movie and is the way we describe a movie. And you can see that the models, it shows up as models in the documentation, is described within the specification here. And then it's also on the left-hand side, and then it's also rendered on the right-hand side. And then ratings is the data structure by which we make a rating. Genre is an enum. The OpenAPI specification allows you to declare enums that can be used within the API. In this case, I said action, comedy, drama, horror, sci-fi, and suspense, because a movie will belong to, at this time, only one genre. And then we have known ratings. And what a known rating is that once a rating has been accepted by the system, it will be given an ID and a create date. Now, what's interesting here is that OpenAPI 2.0 and 3.0 supports the notion of inheritance using what's called the all of attribute or the all of property. And we'll go into detail in another video about how to do inheritance. But know that you can do inheritance under OpenAPI. And if you look closely, you'll see that known rating really descends from rating, because here's rating. And then if we go down here, here's rating, and then known rating has the ID and create date, where rating does not have an ID. And that comes in under here, under this definition. And then finally, we have the user. And the user is really a person using the system, and they have a user email, a username, first name, and last name. And we're going to use the email as an identifier, so there's no need to put an ID in. We'll just use user email, because that'll be used in movies also. Now, granted, some of us that like to fight about data modeling can get into why are we using certain data structures in one part of the API and not using them in the other. And I get that, and there's a lot of good discussion to be having around that. But for now, the focus really is on understanding the basic overview of the OpenAPI specification. A host is where we put the domain under which the API will run. In this case, I'm going to run it on my local machine, so it's localhost. If I was running this in a production or staging or even in a testing situation and using a domain, it would be www.mydomain.com or an IP address. And as we discussed above, base path is the base path in which all calls to the API will enter. Also, schemes at the bottom, that's the last part of the specification, the last attribute or property of the specification. In this case, declares protocols that are supported. Now, what's interesting here is the just-in-time nature of the documentation. Notice here that we're defining HTTPS and HTTP as schemes to be supported under the specification, the Movie Rater API, and notice it's showing up in the documentation. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to decide, well, you know, I really don't want to support HTTP anymore, so I'm going to remove it from my spec. And you can see I've changed the array to have only one element, HTTPS. And then if I go back to the documentation, you'll see that HTTP is gone. Again, in the nice thing about SwaggerHub is that the documentation is real time. The other thing that it will do is if I make an error in the parsing of the JSON, is it'll report it. And right here, we should be getting an error because I've eliminated a quotation mark. So let me see here if I can make a better error. As a matter of fact, let me put things back in here. There's HTTP, and let me corrupt the JSON. Okay, and you can see now that the JSON is corrupted. I'm getting a little red X arrow, and then also this documentation is saying, hey, you've corrupted the JSON, I can't go forward, and this whole spec is invalid. And that's a nice thing about SwaggerHub, is that it will keep an eye on your JSON for you. All right, so there you have it. So again, the overview was the high-level attributes or properties of the OpenAPI 2.0 spec, Swagger info, tags, paths, definitions, host, base, path, and schemes. I'm going to go into much more detail about these in subsequent videos, but I thank you for taking the time to watch now, and I hope you find this useful. Also, I'll put Movie Rater out on GitHub with a link below in the YouTube listing so you can get the actual code if you want to inspect it. Thank you. Thanks for stopping by, and I look forward to seeing you again. Bye.